back to Stuck on an Island, where I'm stuck with you guys and we are always smiling. So right now I'm waiting for dinner to come down the stream. I don't think it will take that long, well, not as long as Judah took to get here, so I'm just waiting. Hey guys, we just caught a fish. I'm joking, I got this from Rainforest Seafood. So pretty much what we're gonna be doing today is going to be snapper. We're doing red snapper today. I told you guys I'm gonna do Aitel, and this is probably one of the most controversial Aitel dishes, because some Rastas will tell you like they don't consume fish, but then some of them will tell you that they're pescatarians and they'll have fish. So what we're gonna be doing today is gonna be an Aitel steam fish. As you guys know, Aitel means you involve no form of salt whatsoever. So what I'm gonna be doing, I am gonna be adding a little bit of salt because I'm trying to slowly get over to the whole process of just cooking with herbs alone. And yeah, that's what we're gonna be doing today. I hope you guys enjoy this video. Remember, if you wanna see us do more videos like this, get this video to, I think last time they got it to 200 like really quick, so nah, I'm saying 400, let's double it. I think you guys can do it because the last video got over a thousand likes, so let's do it and let's get into doing this beautiful dish. All right, so I'm gonna take these spices really quickly. I got some thyme. I like when the thyme is not old, they're not dry, they're pretty fresh. And some escallions, I'm gonna wash those off really quickly and just start prepping every single thing that I'm gonna need for the fish pretty much. Beautiful scotch bonnet pepper here. Give it a quick little wash off. So I just got some, I just did a Maggi season up type of thing.
Absolutely.
And I'm just gonna rub some of this inside of it. If we be honest though, like this thing does have a bit of salt in there. But if you don't want to use any form of salt at all, then definitely don't. But I just find that this is really good on fish. So this for me is just gonna be like the basic seasoning that I'm using on the fish. And maybe a little bit of black pepper. Them type of food, yeah, strong up your back. You understand?
What do we got here, boo?
This coconut oil here is it's not the traditional one that's from Jamaica. This one's actually from Trinidad, but I like this one because it's infused with garlic inside of it, so that's even more flavorful.
Looks nice.
Yeah. Plus, I like the packaging of it a lot. It's really
cute.
Good. So the oil helps too, because you know oil pretty much is a great carrier of flavors. Plus it's going to help the fish to stay moist and super hydrated and soft. So what I'm going to do at the end, I'm going to add the okras in. The okra with the, well, I'm going to add a few of it in there now. Get a few of them going, but I personally like when my vegetables are a little bit more crunchy, meaning like they're not all the way soft or super done.
To put some on the inside.
So we can put some on the inside, no problem. And there we go. That's pretty much what we're gonna do. When it's almost done, I'm gonna add some what you call it, some crackers into it. Hold this bad boy up. And you're good to go. Judah being Judah, she's like, I want to try, babe, and she put herself. But she did her thing.
Guys, I can't cook, you know. Just don't make
no,
the cook
babe,
with you.
Let people tell you that.
So, you, what you trying to say?
No, make people tell you that.
What you trying to say?
Anyway.
Okay.
Guys, luckily I came prepared this time because I know she's gonna hurt herself. So
I went on the floor for my floor band-aid.
Maybe.
So Judah over here pretty much is about to do her like a little shrimp basket, because I know she doesn't eat, you know, fish. So she's about to do some shrimp, some corn, some potato. Want to put potatoes in it?
A little.
A little potatoes, and yeah, I'm about to help her out with that really quick.
Just the potato part.
Because this is pretty simple that she's doing. And yeah, the whole dish in particular is pretty simple. The roast fish is easy. The shrimp and thing is easy. We're just out here having some fun. To be quite honest, let me take that back. It's not that fun. It's fun after like when we're eating and stuff, but like doing the whole process is kind of difficult. But luckily today I had Judah, you know, doing like the little camera work and stuff, because that's the vision that I want for the video. And she's been helping me out big time on that. So thanks, babe. Yeah, so hopefully, you know, the next time we come, because with the whole thing in life, guys, it's about like getting used to a process. Like the first time we came here, it took us a little bit longer to get ready. This time was a bit faster, getting the fire ready and stuff. But this time it's just like the camera technique. So the people been watching the videos and been liking it, liking the food. Thank you guys. Keep watching, keep liking, subscribing. Let's get this video to 400 likes, share it, and we're about to eat some food pretty soon. My dudes, I think Judah's dinner is gonna be late. Nothing to say, babe?
No, he gonna cut me off.
Basket look good. Oh snap.
Mm-hmm.
move. So this is pretty much it. It's about to go in. It's about to go down. Good job, babe.
Thank you.
Woo. I know you guys might be wondering if I should do this. So I remember the last time when I was here and I had the mango in my Snapchat, some people were complaining. So it's about time some of you complain on the vlog. Boy, look at this mango. Beautiful. Is there anyone here that knows to eat a mango without getting their hands messy? I can't. Well, I'm done.
Oh, sorry guys, I didn't see you guys there, honestly.
So we're just gonna do a quick check on the fish to see how far along it came. I honestly wasn't even timing this. I was just using like gut feelings and instincts. But usually steamed fish doesn't take long. Well, fish in general doesn't take long to cook. Oh, look at that. This is beautiful. This is a beautiful steamed fish. Oh, beautiful. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna add some crackers into this really quick and then put it back just close to the fire, but not on the fire anymore. Right here we have Judah's beautiful shrimp basket. You guys already saw inside before, but we are about to behold. Guys, look at this. Beautiful. I can smell the corn, the shrimp, the lemon. Everything on that is gooch. 100% perfection. And then now we got the fish. As I tell you, I like to put my herbs at the end as well. Because when I'm eating it, I want it to be like al dente. You see me? There we go. So now we got the okra looking even fresher. So I like to eat my food. Fish is looking beautiful. Look at that bad boy. Amazing. Alright guys, so once again we're back here about to grub in. Yo, look at this food, man. Oh. Check this food out, man. Oh, just beautiful, man. Look at that.
Yum.
She crazy. But I'm about to get into it. This is my first time actually doing this out here, so you don't know. I won't say it was the easiest. It's a simple dish, but you know, the first time you do anything, take practice. Wow.
It's a nice flavor with the lemon on top. The nice crunch of the what you call it? The okras. It's really good. Now with this, of course, it's not like super salty. It's like I can taste like more of the herbs, like a lot of the herbs. As you guys might see, like my crackers are not like soggy. I don't like it like that, because normally when you cook like anything like steam or roasted or whatever it is, like you need to have contrast. You need to have like something crunchy, something soft. So this was my contrast. Mm-hmm. Look at this girl with the big old pan. Swear. Anyway, guys,
you take a station, baby.
What you doing? I like that. I'm definitely gonna like that a lot because I'm a shrimp guy. I'm not really a steamed fish person. It's just recently I started to, you know, appreciate steamed fish a lot more. I prefer it fried, but like shrimp.
Can't go wrong with shrimp.
Anyway, guys, I'm gonna finish enjoying my meal. Guys, remember, if you like this video, keep giving it some, as I said, 400 likes. That's what we're looking for, because we're about to do this, a vegan type of dessert. I'm gonna call it Rasta. You see me? I'm gonna do that. It's gonna be pretty special. So get it to 400 likes and we'll upload that video for you guys. All right, remember these three things as always: love, nature, adaptation. And always remember, keep the link. And food.
And food.
Bye.
All I am.